I'm just getting ready for the season. I'm just fresh energy in the gym.
Thank you. Next, we'll go to Om.
Welcome back. You were as close as anybody to Montrezl Harrell. You kind of like helped him with his career and everything. How surprised were you to see him end up a Laker this summer? And how does the attitude and personality of this team change without Trez and Doc and all the changes they made?
Business is business. Trez made a decision for himself. So in that aspect, you know, things happen and you move on for it. What was the second part of your question?
How much have things changed from this team from, you know, last time you saw in the playoffs with all the changes they made with Doc gone, Trez, Jamichael Green, and adding Ibaka and Luke?
Well, we're still building. We hadn't even gotten into contact yet. So, you know, we really don't know the true identity of this team yet. So we're still building.
Thank you. Next, we'll go to Farbod.
Welcome back, Lou. You know, I remember the moment the playoffs ended last year, you said, guys are pissed off. And it was one of the first things you said, you know, entering the season right now, is it that same exact level of anger from last season or people, what is the motivation like that you've seen?
I think we've moved on from last year. It's a fresh start. And we're prepared to compete for a championship again with this group. In order for us to move on, we kind of got to let that go, give ourselves an opportunity to have a fresh start and move forward.
Thank you. Next, we'll go to Sabrina Merchant.
Hey, Lou. I'm curious what you know about Luke Kennard's game so far and how you see the two of you guys fitting together in that second unit.
Unfortunately, I haven't been able to watch Luke play a lot. Competing against him, I know he's a shooter. I know he's a tough guy. He competes at a high level. So, just the last 2 days with dummying offense with him and just communicating, I think we'll be a good fit together.
Thanks, Sabrina. Next, we'll go to Tomer.
Hey, Lou. It's good to see you. Hope you had a good offseason. I'm just curious, you're entering the final year of your deal. You know, you're going to be 34. As the thought of, I guess, you know, continuing your career with this franchise or your career in the NBA crept into your mind at all, or are you just focused on, you know, trying to win a championship this year?
I don't think about it all the time, but at the end of the day, I take it one step at a time, take it a day at a time. I'm blessed to be in a position where I'm kind of in control of my destiny after this season. Whether it's moving forward or whether it's not. And I'm excited about this year and competing for a championship. And then once I get to that bridge, I'll deal with it.
You said last year was your best chance at winning a championship. What do you feel about this year?
Well, last year was my best chance last year. So we're moving forward and getting ready for this one.
Thank you. Next is Andrew Gray.
Hi, Lou. Good to see you. Obviously, this is an unusual offseason, both in timing, but also for you. I mean, I've seen your name out there referenced as potential trade talks. I guess, what's this offseason been like just in general for you, from the shortness of it, the uncertainty of it? How have you felt these last couple months?
I just unplugged from basketball and focused on my family and enjoyed the time that I had with them. So I really didn't hear a lot of the noise. You know, my job is to come in and compete on a team that I'm playing for and be a professional. Other than that, I can't deal with things that I can't control.
Thanks, Lou.
Morning, Lou. Can you describe the kind of the vibe that Coach Lou brings to the gym?
So far, it's been good. It's been loose. It's been informative. I'm just getting ready for the season. I'm just fresh energy in the gym.
Thank you.
Next, we'll go to Om.
Lou, welcome back. You were as close as anybody to Montrezl Harrell. You kind of like helped him with his career and everything. How surprised were you to see him end up a Laker this summer? And how does the attitude and personality of this team change without Trez and Doc and all the changes they made?
Business is business. Trez made a decision for himself, so in that aspect, you know, things happen and you move on for it. What was the second part of your question?
How much have things changed from this team from, you know, last time you saw in the playoffs with all the changes they made with Doc on Trez, Jamichael Green, and adding Ibaka and Luke?
Well, we're still building. We hadn't even gotten into contact yet. So, you know, we really don't know the true identity of this team yet. So we're still building.
Thank you. Next, we'll go to Farbod.
Welcome back, Lou. You know, I remember the moment the playoffs ended last year, you said, guys are pissed off. And it was one of the first things you said, you know, entering the season right now, is it that same exact level of anger from last season or people, what is the motivation like that you've seen?
I think we've moved on from last year. It's a fresh start. And we're prepared to compete for a championship again with this group. In order for us to move on, we kind of got to let that go, give ourselves an opportunity to have a fresh start and move forward.
Thank you. Next, we'll go to Sabrina Merchant.
Hey, Lou. I'm curious what you know about Luke Kennard's game so far and how you see the two of you guys fitting together in that second unit.
Unfortunately, I haven't been able to watch Luke play a lot. Competing against him, I know he's a shooter. I know he's a tough guy. He competes at a high level. So just the last 2 days with dummy and offense with him and just communicating, I think we'll be a good fit together.
Thanks, Sabrina. Next, we'll go to Tomer.
Hey, Lou. It's good to see you. Hope you had a good offseason. I'm just curious, you're entering the final year of your deal. You're going to be 34. Has the thought of, I guess, you know, continuing your career with this franchise or your career in the NBA crept into your mind at all? Or are you just focused on, you know, trying to win a championship this year?
I don't think about it all the time, but at the end of the day, I take it one step at a time, take it a day at a time. I'm blessed to be in a position where I'm kind of in control of my destiny after this season. Whether it's moving forward or whether it's not. So I'm excited about this year and competing for a championship. And then once I get to that bridge, I'll deal with it.
You said last year was your best chance at winning a championship. What do you feel about this year?
Well, last year was my best chance last year. So we're moving forward and getting ready for this one.
Thank you. Next is Andrew Gray.
Hi, Lou. Good to see you. Obviously, this is an unusual offseason, both in timing, but also for you. I mean, I've seen your name out there referenced as potential trade talks. I guess, what's this offseason been like, just in general, for you, from the shortness of it, the uncertainty